Jen. Hey, we have another story about courage this week. Would you like to hear it? The story is about a woman named Lydia, and you can find her story in the book of Acts. It's in chapter 16. Now, what's happening in this part of Acts is that Paul and his friend Silas and their friend Timothy and Luke are all traveling together, and they're going from town to town telling people the message of Jesus. And on the way, they meet Lydia. And it says, "On the Sabbath, we went outside the Philippi city gate to the river, where we expected to find a place of prayer. We sat down and began to speak to the women who had gathered there. One of those listening was a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira, who was a worshiper of God." Okay, so Lydia's Jewish. She knows God, she loves God, she worships God. She's also a businesswoman. She sells purple cloth. The Lord opened her heart to respond to Paul's message. When she and the members of her household were baptized, she invited us to her home. "If you consider me a believer in the Lord," she said, "then come, stay at my house." And she persuaded us. That's pretty much the whole story of Lydia, except for one more thing. Later, Paul and Silas get thrown into prison. They were accused of teaching things that were illegal for Romans to do. And later, they had found out they were Roman citizens and it was not okay to just throw them into jail. They had to have a trial, which they didn't get. So then the officials ask Paul and Silas to please leave the town very nicely. And instead, they go back to Lydia's house. They had built a relationship with her and her family and they knew they could trust her. It's a really interesting story. Why do you think we're using this as a story about courage? What did Lydia do that was courageous? You give up? I'll tell you. Lydia was the first believer in Jesus in this whole region, the region that we now refer to as Europe. Nobody else she knew was a believer in Jesus. So when Paul and Silas and Timothy and Luke show up talking about Jesus, it was a completely brand new concept. As they were talking to her and the other women, she must have had a feeling in her heart that this was true, that it was right. But she was probably also kind of afraid. Not only did she not know these men from anywhere, she didn't know anyone else who thought like them or believed like them. Also, she was a businesswoman. She had a reputation in the community. She sold purple cloth, which was a specialty. Purple dye was expensive and often used as a sign of royalty. So she had an important business to uphold, and she probably didn't want everyone to think that she was strange or it could affect her business badly. What should she do? Well, as we know from the story, she decided to believe. And after she's baptized and her whole family is baptized, she welcomes these guys into her house, even though she doesn't know them. And then after they get thrown into jail and they're in trouble with the authorities, she welcomes them back into her house, even though she might have been a little worried about the authorities becoming suspicious of her and her family. Lydia is an example of courage. Courage is choosing the right thing to do, even though you're afraid. Courage means not letting fear stop you from doing what you know in your heart is right. So this week, how can we be like Lydia? How can we choose to do what we know is right, even if we're afraid that others might think we're weird, and it might affect our reputation badly, or what people think of us? Now that school has started again, we have lots of opportunities, I'm sure,